If you are a consultant, then you probably know the power of email. It will be the leading place where you're going to see the most conversion for your sales. Very few people buy things directly online or on social media. It's through email that you really connect with your audience. So what does your email funnel look like? Well, in this video, I'm gonna be breaking down how you can use AI, ChatGPT, to help you set up that email funnel. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I own Gap Consulting. We're $1 million a year consulting business. But this video is being brought to you by Built to Scale. Built to Scale is my second brand. And here we are all about helping other people achieve financial freedom for themselves by becoming no-code consultants. There is so much pent-up demand for no-code consulting right now. If you know how to use a software and you like working online, well, my friend, you should consider becoming a no-code consultant. And to help you get started, I want to invite you to join me for my crash course. It's a 5-day email crash course. It's going to teach you the fundamental pieces of becoming your own consultant and helping you earn your first $1,000 online. If that's of interest, check that out at built2scale, that's the number 2.io. Link will be below this video in the description. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of this video. We are going to be talking about how you can use ChatGPT, OpenAI, to help you write that email funnel. Now, full transparency, when I started Gap Consulting, I knew I needed an email funnel, but I put it off for far too long. It was months and months and months into the process, and by this point, I was already overwhelmed with all of the different stuff that was going on in running my business. I wound up spending tens of thousands of dollars to bring in a really good email funnel specialist. The truth of it is, I think a lot of that work we could have done ourselves if we just had a little bit more courage and understanding in what this whole thing is about. So my goal here is to help you get set up for free or for at least very little money so that you can build your own email funnel. And maybe it's not perfect. These things are living and breathing. They're always going to improve over time. But what I hope for you is that it gets better over time, but at least this gives you a starting point. So let's imagine the following. Let's say, for example, I was sitting down and I was ready to plan out my own Airtable crash course. I have a funnel like this, and over a few days, I'm sending out emails that talk about the different features of Airtable. Of course, I offer this for free if people come and visit my website and sign up with their email, but the advantage here is once I capture that email, I can stay top of mind and really build that relationship with my prospective client. That's what I'm envisioning for you here as well. But let's go ahead and start out by mapping this in Airtable. You could use a spreadsheet, you could use Smart Suite, you could use Notion, whatever software you're most comfortable with. But the idea here is that as I create new records, I want to kind of identify what they are. Each of these is going to be its own email in the process. I'm going to need to record things like, what is the day of this particular email? Let's use a number here. Now, for email funnels, we usually start with the number 0 for the date that it first starts. So when somebody signs up, that's day 0. The next one goes out on day 1 or maybe day 2. The next one after that on day 2 or 3, depending on how you want to structure this. So I could build all the different days in my funnel. Now I want to talk about the main topic. So what is the main topic of this particular thing? In my case, I'll set up a quick single line text and I'll say, the main topic here is a data schema. So how you would organize data in Airtable. On my next day, I might say something like Airtable automations. On my next day, I might say something like Airtable interfaces. You get the idea. The whole key or the whole components of this is I'm coming up with specific topics that I'll be talking about on the various days inside of my email funnel. Now, the next piece of this is going to be the actual email subject line, which we don't have just yet. And so I'll go ahead and create a field here for this. And I will also create an email body here where I bring in a long text field. And this is where I'm going to drop in the email copy itself. Now, to wrap this all up, what I might add here on my primary field is just going to be a quick formula that's going to concatenate different information here. I'll take my main topic and I'll add to this a dash space dash and the day. And this will be a nice way to round out what each of these is. So this is my data schema email, goes out on day 0. My Airtable automations email goes out on day 1. You get the idea. So, we can also attach additional stuff here. I really love video, which should come as no surprise to you. So maybe I also want to add some video files, whatever other pieces of information I need here in order to build out this funnel and keep all my information in one place. But here's for the daunting part, at least for me. I hate writing copy. I hate writing email subjects. I always feel like I'm not doing it full justice. And it just makes me, in general, just nervous. And that's probably why I've spent a ridiculous amount of money getting other people to do this for me. So, what do I want to do here? Well, again, I want to encourage you to start leveraging the power of ChatGPT and at least giving you a building block so that we don't have to write this stuff from scratch. So, let's go into ChatGPT. I've got my playground open up here. You can just use the free version if you can get in, or you might need to subscribe to the new monthly plan because due to high volume, ChatGPT is really hard to access these days if you're not paying for it. Let's go ahead and drop in, and I'll just write a simple prompt. Help me write an email about Airtable automations that will help educate my users about the importance of this feature. Let's start with this and see what we get back. I'll submit this and sit back. The lovely part about ChatGPT is it did the whole thing for me, right? It came in and even wrote the subject here, and it's bringing in some liquid text, right? Some variables by saying, hey, you have an email list. Let's go ahead and assume that you're going to plug in the name of the person here. So it's really that simple, right? Let's go ahead and copy this. And now I can go back into my email funnel here. I can come over to my email body here for Airtable Automations, expand that, and I'll just Control V or Apple V, paste in that particular email. And again, I'll do the same thing here with the subject. So there we go. Grab it, drop it in. Easy peasy. So you get the idea. I could go in and have all of this crafted for me automatically through ChatGPT. Now, of course, I don't recommend sending this out without first proofreading it, which I haven't even done here. So I would definitely want to go through this with a fine-toothed comb and make sure that it properly demonstrates the value of Airtable Automations. But you'll notice that they've even included parts in here for me to include my link to a tutorial and all kinds of different things along those lines. So this is great. This is going to help you get streamlined, up and running faster with your email funnels. Now, I challenge you to take this even a step further. If you wanted to, you could build an automated process with ChatGPT that once you filled out this information in your Airtable database, you could push or send that information to ChatGPT, ask it to give you this information back, and bring back the subject and email body. If you're curious about that process, check out a recent video we did where we showed how to do this with social media posts, scheduling them from Airtable using ChatGPT. Now, that's it for this video. I want to encourage you to get out there and write your own email funnel. At the end of this all, after you've provided a ton of value to your prospective clients, don't forget to remind them about the services that you offer and ask them to take the next step with you, whether that's scheduling a call, buying a course, or whatever it is that you might be selling as a no-code consultant. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. If you did, be sure you've subscribed to this channel, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Until then, keep on building. If you're interested in that, check out If you're curious about that current... One more time. I will get there. Watch me.